Good afternoon, children. Good afternoon. Just afternoon, children. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, Darshan. Okay. Good afternoon, children. Good afternoon. Children, as I was saying, the video, I've told you that you watch the video carefully because the video, like it was related to the chapter one, that is conversion. We have combined two chapters, children, in your NCERT book. If you're going to see, we have two chapters which are combined. We have like a it is combustion and it is coal and petroleum. So we have just combined because combustion, flame and petrol, okay, it's together, like it is really interrelated. So we have combined the chapters. So we have combined both the chapters, that is combustion and flame and good afternoon, children. Good afternoon. And combustion and flame, and then something related to coal and petroleum. Okay, so today, children, today we will be, I think so, everybody has observed the chapter one. Okay, good afternoon, Shashank. Yes, I can read your names. That's good. You're introducing yourself. Good afternoon. Yes, Romanzia, good afternoon. Children, today we are going to begin with our chapter two, our second chapter of chemistry, and that chapter is very like we use it in our day-to-day life. Those materials we use it in our day-to-day life. Yes, Pranjalia. Yeah, I can understand, children. I am familiar to you now. Don't worry. I can understand who is every 8th standard, who is regular in joining the class. Yes, Zuni. Yes, okay. Nikita. Good morning, children. Still some students are joining. Till that, we will be just seeing what we have seen in the previous chapter. So you close it up. Good afternoon, children. Good afternoon. Yeah, just close it up. Yeah, good. Thank you. Okay, children, we'll be starting with our next chapter, that is chapter two. Okay, it's our chemistry chapter two. It's not the textbook chapter two. We will be starting with the chapter second, that is the next chapter. First chapter, which we have seen, was the combustion fuel and the flame. These three concepts we have studied. And in chapter two now, children, keep in mind, children, just remember, like whatever you're going to learn in your class eight now. Okay, same things, same chapters you have for your class 10th. Keep in mind, 8th and 9th is not at all linked. 8th and 9th is not at all linked, but 8th and 10th is linked, children. As it is, whatever you have in your chemistry part, same chapters you have for your class 10th. So whatever you are going to study, I know it's online, we are dealing in such a manner, but do not worry, children. As days pass, you have to just try to make your own notes and study. Do not take in a very lenient way that yes, let it be, it's a lockdown time, I'm studying through online classes, there is an excuse. But children, keep in mind, same chapters, just remember, same chapters, whatever you are going to study, it's there for your class 10th. Okay, it's there for your class 10, so do not neglect it. Okay, so children, we will be beginning. Let's last 1 minute, and we will be starting with our chapter next, new chapter. It's a very different chapter because same as it is, the same chapter you have for your class 10. Same chapter. Chapter's name is metals and non-metals. Okay, we are going to study about metals and non-metals. Children, actually these substances like metals and non-metals, like we have. Like we use it, children, in our day-to-day life. We make use of those materials. The thing is, chemistry will teach you what are the chemistry is going to make you aware that whatever substances you are using in your day-to-day life, those substances are like they are classified as metals and non-metals. Okay, let's see, children. I'm going to begin. I think I just plan to wait because once I start sharing, students they start joining. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Yes, Annapurna. Okay, fine. Okay, good afternoon, Bhargavi. I think so. I should start, children. Good afternoon. Yes, good afternoon. I think I'm audible, children. You can listen to me. You can audible. Fine, fine. Okay. So till now, again, yes, good afternoon. Good afternoon. So many messages. Good afternoon, children. Good afternoon. Okay, once again, I'm going to say good afternoon now. It's going to be my Anushka. Okay, Anushka. Anushka is, I think, sports player. Yes, Anushka, Samarth. Yes, Samarth. Familiar to you, children. Yes, I think so. Yeah, I'm familiar. Don't worry, I know. Looking at the faces, at least I will identify you and by your names here and there. I can identify you all. Don't worry. Because it's not a first day. Yes, let's some students are joining. Dipti, yes, I'm aware. Yeah, I know. Good morning. Who is this? Good morning. Your morning. Yeah. It's afternoon, dear. It's wonderful. Almost lunchtime. I feel so bad because my class will be during lunchtime. I hope so. Because your videos are off. I feel that, yeah, good afternoon, dear. But I feel that you shouldn't sleep. Like, I don't know what you're doing there because you're just listening to me or you're just. Sometimes, like just you're sitting and yawning, you shouldn't do that. The children listen to me carefully, okay? Yeah, good afternoon, dear. No, what sorry and all, it's fine because it's lockdown. We feel like it's Sunday, Monday, it's one only now. Sundays, at least every day, look, we feel like Sunday, don't because we don't have school, children. We are in our regular routine, it may happen. Sometimes even I forget. Now, if I'm going to ask you the date, even you will be thinking because once we enter the class on the board, the date will be written. Gaurish, yes. Yes, then only we'll come to know, yes, it's morning time. We have entered the class date. Nicely, it's displayed on the board. It's so fresh, children, fresh feeling when we come to school, when we join the school. But here, this kind of online classes, just you get the knowledge, just you get time to interact with teachers. This is a kind of interaction. Okay, this is a kind of interaction, but that's a different feeling when we are there in the classroom, when we are there in the school. That's a different feeling. Okay, I'm going to start now, children. It's Saish. Yes, Saish. Everybody has watched the video, children. Saish, good videos I have received from few students. Nice efforts they have taken. Yeah, very good, children. Like you have participated, Shashank, Saish, and one more is there, I think Saksham. Three students have sent me the videos. They have tried it very nicely. Not tried, but they have done their best. Even other students, I want, like, now just don't send me the videos. I'll send you some other activity. Yes, Saish, thank you. Okay, fine. Very good. It's good. Very confident. I feel that you all are very confident, children. Okay, like, I feel so. Let's start, children. I'll not waste my time now. Okay. Let's start. Samran. Okay. Okay. That's it, children. That's it. Okay, Shashank. It was good, children. Like your presentation, I thought you're so small. You're in 8th standard. How come you will be presenting? Because when I was entering your class, like I felt that your presentation is good. You all are very confident. The thing is, I'm waiting for your papers now. Let's see because I've never checked your papers. How you're writing. Let's see that because you will be judged by your papers at the end. Okay, that's end, children. My talks are end. I'm going to end my other talks. Let's come back to chemistry. Part one, that is last few days, we are discussing. Okay, we correct on Monday. Monday, the last period is chemistry, and there's still so many days like till since last month. Yes, Bhumi. Yes, Bhumi. Fine, fine. Okay, since last week, children, we have studied about the previous chapter, and in that previous chapter, I have combined two chapters. Children, remember, I have combined two chapters. One is coal, petroleum. Also, that's a very simple chapter which I have combined with combustion and flame. Okay, children, now in this part two, today I'm going to start with chapter two. That is metals and non-metals. Children, there are so many things around us. Okay, now I have so many things. Whatever I have, I'm going to show. I have a book. Okay, I have this bottle. I have my head. Yeah, this is one head hairband. These are the headphones. So there's so just whatever was there around me, I've just shown you because nothing, I didn't carry anything. So just these, this hairband, headphones, then earphones. This is my bottle. So whatever things I have, whatever things you have around you now, children, just once you take a, just have a look. Chemistry says that, okay, chemistry, according to chemistry, these all materials, okay, these all, I have my hairband, headphones, these all materials are classified as metals and non-metals, okay, there's a story behind it, children, there's a short story, it's not a story, actually, it's about the discovery. Like in the olden era, in the very, just go back to many long thousands and thousand years. So during Rajas and Mahara, before Rajas, kings and time, like when man started observing the nature, because man, like our ancestors are monkeys, everybody knows, we have some traits like ape man, okay, you have seen the sages, stone age man, ape man, we have well developed brain, we have well developed body. So we actually have come from our ancestors, those are ape, those are monkeys usually, yeah, we say monkeys. So children, let's go back to those days, children. As man started observing the nature, he thought that every material in this nature can be brought to use, it can be brought in use, we can make use of it. Okay, we can make use of it. Like simple rock was, rock started it started sliding down the floor, down the mountain or the hill. Looking at that, the wheel, that was an invention of wheel. So simple, when two pebbles or the stones were rubbed, okay, when scrubbed together, there was invention of fire, discovery of fire. We learn in history that there are different eras where fire was introduced, where wheel was introduced. So children, as man started, when fire was introduced, man started cooking food, because only previously man used to hunt animals, man used to hunt and kill animals, and raw animals were eaten up, like fruits and all, simple, it was eaten up by man. But further, when man started thinking, okay, as man is a it's a brilliant animal, we also animal which has the best brain, best thinking power. So as man started thinking, okay, he started thinking, looking at the nature, rocks, pebbles, hills. So on the earth surface, okay, previously on the earth surface, different colors, different types of rocks were introduced. Okay, man observed there is something different, because already it was there on the earth surface. But once man started thinking, he started thinking, what actually is this? Why it is golden in color? Why it is silver in color? Why it is blue in color? Why this rock is something different? So as man started thinking, children, some type of elements were introduced. Okay, elements means according to the old Rishi Munis, whatever we see around us, according to them, okay, whatever we see around us, it comes of the fan. Shreyas. Okay. Children, whatever we see around us, it is made up of the pancha tattva or five elements. Okay, the five elements. So children, now after when man started thinking, Shreyas of the fan. Yes, from the nature man started, then he thought some elements, when the elements were introduced, copper, gold, silver, then Rajas and Maharajas, kings and queens, they started using the gold plates, the silver articles. So those articles were brought in use, those materials were brought in use. Then scientists came forward that there are so many elements introduced now. There were 33 elements introduced, copper, gold, silver, zinc. then these elements were introduced. So how to study them, where to keep them, okay, it was very interesting fact that once the elements were introduced, how you're going to study, where, like how we know that yes, gold can be used for making the materials, but only plastic, steel can be used for making such articles. How man came to know about these, some elements and all. So how to study them? So man came, like scientists came forward with their ideas to place the elements, to study the elements properly. Now, let's take example, children. You have a cupboard in your house. Everybody has wardrobe in your house. So in the wardrobe, we keep the clothes very systematically. Some one corner we will keep for the party wear clothes. One corner will be for the uniform, one section will be for your father, your mother, siblings, brother, sisters. Okay, we will be having some separate sections. Same way, children, if you are going to dump everybody's clothes in one cupboard, is it going to be systematic? Are you going to get the clothes on time, on correctly? You're going to pull all the clothes and you're going to take out the clothes? No, you won't do that. For that, we need systematic arrangement. We need proper arrangement in the wardrobe, in the house also. Your mother, she keeps everything very systematically, like cup and saucer in one corner, glassware's in one corner. Yes, your sister does that. Yes, small, they do that. All thing dumping in one corner, toys and all, everything. But just look at your mother, children. Your mother is so perfect. She keeps everything. Yeah, she's small. She does. Even I have one mess in my house. So he does all the mess. It may happen. Small kids, they do. But it's your, when you observe your mother, she shouts at you, keep everything systematically. Yes, every time your mother will be, every time your mother will be, your mother keeps everything very systematically. She says, keep everything properly, keep this, because if you observe in the kitchen, she's going to keep all the, in the refrigerator also, spices will be in one place, all the dal she's going to keep in one place, rice, vegetables in one place. Nicely, everything is organized in your mom's kitchen. Also, it is organized in your house. You have to just say thanks to your mother. The same thing, children, when the elements were introduced, scientists, they thought how to study them, how to systematically study them, because everything, it is organized in everybody's house because of your mother. Yes, your mother, nicely, she keeps everything and she guides you to keep it properly. Your mother tells, she's going to inform you, just keep this properly, keep your toys properly, keep your books properly. Same thing, children, scientists also, when the elements were introduced, 33 elements were introduced. Gold, silver, copper, as I have told you, zinc, 33 elements were introduced. And then man, scientists thought that how to study them, how to keep it them, because we need to study it systematically. Yes, we need to keep it systematically. So scientists came forward with the periodic table. Different scientists came. Yeah, different. Three scientists came forward with their ideas. Yes, we will keep it like that. We will place it in this idea, in this manner. All the 33 elements will keep in this order. So when the elements, copper, zinc were introduced, many people came forward. Scientists also made, they gave their ideas. Further, their children, scientists thought of making a complete periodic table. Okay, they introduced a periodic table where the elements were set up or where the elements were given their proper places. Now, this periodic table is the base of our chemistry. Okay, in the periodic table, you're going to find nicely metals, non-metals, gases, everything is arranged. As everybody, like maximum students have joined, I'll just go back and I'll share my screen. I'm there. I'm not going anywhere, children. Okay, I'm just going to share my screen, children, and I'm going to show you the systematic, how your mother, so nicely, she keeps the house properly. Even a scientist, they came forward and they have arranged the elements. Those elements were arranged in the periodic table. This arrangement is in a very systematic way, is in very proper way, in such a way that all the metals have joined the, yeah, all the metals, if you observe, they have come together to form, you can see the red color ones, which are colored red. The red color boxes are, I think so, I'm just assuming, children, you can see the picture. Just observe the colors, that's it, don't read the other parts, yeah? The red ones, okay? The red ones are the metals, whatever materials we use around us, whatever is not around us, whatever we observe, whatever we use in our houses. So those materials which are colored in red, that are the metals. Okay, those are the metals. And the blue ones are the non-metals. If you observe the last column, HeNeAr, that is helium, neon, argon, the last corners are the laziest ones. Okay, they are the lazy. Well, how we are the lazy? Sometimes we, lockdown has like advantage, we take advantage of lockdown, we don't react, we don't do anything sometimes. So same with the last column, if you observe He, the blue last column, that is HeNeArK, that is helium, neon. I'm just going to zoom it so that you can understand. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. If you observe, these are, they are the laziest ones because they you will study about valency, they are already satisfied, they don't react with anything. Okay, so they don't react with anything, they're the very aram se wale gases. They are actually all the gases, they are the noble gases. These blue ones, okay, these blue ones, whichever are there, those are the non-metals. Carbon, N for nitrogen, O for oxygen, F for fluorine. These, whichever blue ones you can see, those are the non-metals. And the red ones, so many red elements. Yeah, you can see so many elements are marked with, are colored with red. Those elements are the metals. Okay, now just now I said that what are the metals, like just I'm going on saying about the metals, non-metals. Okay, and yellow ones, nobody had asked me. Children, yellow ones are the exception. Okay, look at the yellow one. They are like boundary. They are in the center. They are they are between metals as well as non-metals. That means they're in the center and they behave like metals and sometimes they behave like a non-metal. Okay, not like like if you observe, I'll just give show you my like some live examples which I have around me, which are the they are the metalloids. They are called as the metalloids. Metalloids, look at this. I'll just show you the spelling. Metalloids. Yellow ones are the metalloids. Metalloids have like, they behave like metals also and they behave like non-metals. Okay, they have the properties of metals and they have the properties, they behave like non-metals also. Now children, what is this? Everyone has to repeat, you are going to repeat what actually it is. Everyone, I'm going to ask you a question. What the elements are arranged in the systematic order in dash, what it is? Very good. What it is, everyone? It is the periodic table. The elements are, very good, children. The elements are arranged in the periodic table. Now just tell me, the blue ones are dash. Non-metal. Very good, children. Non-metal. The last one. Oh, the last one with a very good, children. Oh. Non-metal. Very good. Okay, okay. Very good. The last one, children, the last column. The last column, helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon. They are the noble gases. They are the, these one, children. Look at this. These one, these blue ones, helium, neon. You can see the last one, laziest ones. They are least bothered. What is going on? Apne baju mein kya ho raha hai? Samajh mein nahi aa raha, because they are relaxed. They are noble gases. They are already inert. So these blue ones, the last column, if you observe, helium, neon, they are noble gases. They are noble ones. They are inert ones. Kuch lena nahi, dena nahi. They are very aram se wale gases. Okay. And these yellow ones are the metalloids. They are the metalloids. They behave, they have the properties of metals as well as non-metals. Okay. So let's see, children. I'm just, once again, further, children. Let's see further. I'm just going to, the lesson's name is metals and non-metals, as I have to introduced. Okay, now today, children, today in this session, we have seen the periodic table and we are going to study the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Physical properties means what, children? I think I have told you earlier, but again and again, I'll just tell you something. Physical property, if I'm saying about the physical property, if I have an apple in front, I'm just going to keep an apple in front of you. So if I'm going to ask you to describe the apple, you're going to tell me, miss, it is round, it is red in color, it is like, it has some dots, yellowish dots on it. So looking at the outer structure, when you describe something, that are the physical properties. Physical properties means bahar ke properties. Like for example, looking at the sky, I'm going to ask you to describe the sky. Sky is blue in color. Sky has, you can see the clouds. You can see birds flying there. Yeah, you're going to describe, you're going to look at whatever you see, the physical properties. Physical properties means bahar ke properties. So now in this chapter, we will be studying about the physical properties and chemical properties of metals as well as non-metals. Okay, we are going to study the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Let's start, children. So we are going to classify the mute. They are never going to do. I think I only have to do take action every time. Yes, I only have. It's my duty. It has become it's already muting. Everybody has muted and nobody speaking. Sometimes if they want to ask something. Yeah, somebody speaking and yeah, don't unmute it, children. Until and unless if I ask you something, please. Every time I have to just go on checking. Okay, let's see, children. Now we are going to see the physical properties of metals and non-metals, and we are going to compare them, and we are going to study, children. We will compare them, like how are metals and how are non-metals. We will compare and we are going to study. Let's start. So the first physical property is luster. Luster means shine. Are you using like any what type of jewelry your mother likes? Like, just I'm going to ask you a question. Gold jewelry she will prefer, or she is going to prefer some mud terracotta or wood jewelry? Many of the mummies, gold, yes, because obviously gold jewelry, children. Gold has perfect shine. They shine. The diamonds, diamonds will keep an exception, children. Okay, diamonds, it's a non-metal, will keep an exception. Children, all the metals, it may be iron, silver, gold, whatever metals we see around us, we use, those have perfect shine. Copper has shine. So if I'm saying that they have shine, means we are going to say that they have luster. The meaning of luster is shiny. Okay, so all the metals, they are lustrous. Okay, they are lustrous. Whereas the non-metals, okay, whatever non-metals are there, they are non-lustrous. Metals are lustrous. Somebody has, I think I have to go on checking every time who is not. What's wrong with you, children? Yeah, this fellow, mute it. Children, if you are not going to mute it, I'm going to sit and I'm do that work then. I'll waste my time there. One minute at least I've wasted to see who has. Yeah, I have to just go on checking. Please don't do that, children. If you want to speak, message me in the middle. I'll just check up your message. Don't worry. But don't speak, children, okay? If I'm asking doubts, then only you can just unmute it and you can speak out, children. So the first physical property of metals and non-metals, this question will be asked in your paper in different application-based, children. Like you have to apply, like for example, it will be asked in the give reason pattern. Give reason pattern means why do we prefer metal, like lustrous jewelry? Why do we prefer silver jewelry? So there you have to answer that this is due to the physical property of metal that they have luster. Okay, so this is the first differentiation of metals and non-metals, that metals have shining surface and non-metals, they have dull surface. Shining opposite is dull. So keep in mind, metals have a luster, whereas non-metals are dull. They have dull surface or they are non-lustrous. This is the first property of metals and non-metals. Let's see the second property, hardness. All the metals, children, they are very hard. imagine your whole building where you are sitting now, children, your whole house is totally dependent on the iron bars which were used for the construction. When the construction step is going on, look at the basic skeleton of the construction site, children. They use the iron bars. Just imagine, children, the windows, the doors, the window panes, everything is made up of iron. Is it like, and is there it everywhere? Like, it, they can't dare to make the house glass. Complete is a glass house, nice. Nobody will dare it. Fine, some places we can install glasses, but not the complete building cannot be constructed with the help of a glass, or it cannot be constructed. Yeah, it's going to break on you, obviously. So this is the property of metals and non-metals, like hardness. All the metals are very tough, very hard, whereas non-metals are soft. They're very soft. Let's take example. If I'm speaking about metals and non-metals, children, if I'm speaking about metals, just imagine about gold, silver, iron, copper, those materials. When I'm speaking about non-metals, because I didn't give you any examples, just think about oxygen. We are breathing in oxygen. Yeah. Is that we can build, imagine we can build, construct a house of oxygen? No, it's not possible. Yeah, oxygen is in the gaseous state. Carbon, when it's anything burns, it gives a black color substance. Okay, is it possible that we can construct something about with a charcoal house, coal house? Is anywhere you have heard it, my house is of coal? Nowhere, children. Yeah, no, my house is of oxygen. Nowhere you have heard about these things. So this is the first, this is the second differentiation of metals and non-metals. That is, all the metals are hard and all the non-metals are soft. Okay, obviously they are soft. Let's take the third differentiation, that is malleability. Say everyone, malleability. Everyone, malleability. Everyone has to see malleability. It's not proper, malleability. Malleability is the property. Malleability, I'll just read it. Malleability, it's like Malayalam, something you're saying, but it's a good word, children. Malleability. You can ability, something is ability, that's the malleability. Okay, malleability. So what actually is malleability? The property of malleability is when you can beat anything. Okay, don't beat your sister or brother. Now you can beat anything into thin sheets. Okay, you can make thin sheets of any material. Okay, like for example, let's take example of iron. Iron at least best example, children, if you are dealing with metals. Now, if you want to make a house, okay, if you want to make a roof. So, if the roofing system, now if you are staying in observe the shop's roofs or the shop doors, obviously, easily you can see that iron sheets are easily, like we can convert iron into, iron is available in the solid rock form. But easily we can beat into sheets. We can make sheets out of it and we can make iron roofs, which is used for making the house roof or the any roofing system, sliding doors, anything, children. So this is the property which all the metals they have, that the property is it can be beaten into sheets. Okay, nice. We can convert into sheets. But non-metals are so soft. Oxygen sheets have. Is it available anywhere? Oxygen sheets? Nowhere. Carbon sheets? It's very difficult, children. Carbon, like coal sheets? Never. It's not possible because they are very soft, children. So they can, but they can be broken into pieces. When you beat it, when you beat any metal, it will get converted into a sheet. But when you beat a non-metal, it will do tukde tukde. You will get all the broken pieces. It's not going to form any kind of sheets. Okay, so this is the third differentiation, that is the property, physical property of malleability. So the first property was luster. The second property was hardness. Okay, and the third property is malleability. Okay, malleability means anything which can be converted into sheet. Even when we go wear gold jewelry, yeah, they are nice into the necklace. You have lots and lots of designs of necklace, earrings. You can see that obviously if you beat into sheets only, then only gold can be converted into that thin necklace. Yeah, nice designs can be given to that necklace. So only this is because of the property of malleability. yeah, because of the malleability. Iron, gold, silver, anywhere it can be used, because it can be easily beaten into sheets. But obviously non-metals, they do not have the property of malleability. Yeah, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, they are very weird. They are very soft ones. They can be broken into pieces, but they cannot be beaten into sheets. Okay, let's proceed. The fourth property is ductility. Ductility. Okay, say everyone, ductility. I'll just malleability, ductility. Malleability, ductility. Okay, this is ductility. Okay. Malleability is the property, okay? Malleability is the property of beating into sheets. Ductility is the property where the materials can be molded into wires. That means we can make wires out of it. Okay, have you seen oxygen wires anywhere? Children, we need oxygen. Patients need oxygen these days, children. But nowhere, we have never seen any oxygen sheets or oxygen wires, or we have never seen carbon sheets or carbon charcoal sheets or charcoal wire. Never. Because non-metals, they do not have the property. When you beat them, when you try to convert them into wire, it's not possible. But metals, they have the property of ductility. They are ductility, that means they can be converted into wires. So gold wires, yeah, gold rings, you are wearing gold rings, silver rings, yeah, gold chains and all, yeah. So only because we can mold it into wire, we can convert into wire, because all the metals, they have the property of ductility. So let's see, children, the first property of was lustrous, that is shiny. Second property was hardness. Third property was malleability. And the fourth property just now we have seen, that is ductility. Let's proceed. The fifth property is conduction of heat. For this, I need to show you something. But before that, I'll just explain. Then I'll proceed to show you the pictures. Children, conduction of heat. Children, nowadays we don't travel here and there, but at least you know about the conductor. When a conductor, bus conductor, without... Once you end, like, because it's not that, miss, don't tell me this, I've never traveled by bus, nobody is going to do that show off in front of me. Because once in a life, children, you know, you should know, like, since first standard, these people, they help for, do they do something for our so, like, they are just helping, like, so we have seen that helpers, like doctors, they are the doctors, policemen, then they are soldiers, these are all the like, they help, they do something for the society. Same way, children, we have seen, like, one fellow which is least, like, nobody discusses about him. That is the conductor, children, the bus conductor, yeah, ticket collector. So if you observe the bus conductor, he gives you the ticket. Without that ticket, without that conductor, can you travel from one place to another? No. Because at the end, what is going to happen? Somebody will catch you and you will be thrown away from, we will be thrown away from the vehicle. So children, that conductor, yeah, that conductor plays a vital role. Yeah, he or she, whoever it is, he or she helps us. That conductor gives us the ticket, which helps us in the traveling process. Because of the ticket, because of the conductor only, we can travel from one place to the another. Same way, children, same way, why I have related, because conductor word we use in our day-to-day life, that is bus conductor, then train also, we have the ticket collector. Same way, children, here also, there are many conductors, okay? There are many conductors. They also do the same thing. They pass something from, they help to pass something from one place to another. And the best conductors are present in a house. Okay, in the wiring system, children, switch on. Once you switch on the button, immediately the current is passed through the wires, and immediately, is that when you on the button, the next day will fan will yeah, it's going to get on, or light will after 1 hour it's going to on? No, children. As soon as your mother ons the grinder, you can just listen to the sound and it works like very quickly, because of those conductors which are present in the wire. Okay, because they help to conduction. That main process is conduction. So what type of conduction? Here we are going to study the conduction of heat. How the heat is conducted. Okay, there are some conductors. They conduct the heat. They conduct heat. So here, children, all the metals, they conduct heat.
Okay, heat, garmi, that is like when you keep something on the, like we cannot you make use of any, like if I have the containers made up of plastic. Nowadays, at least everything is here and there used up, children, but mainly your mother, like even we prefer steel vessels, aluminium vessels for cooking food. Because fine, there is a trend now, they use wooden vessels, they use like they have not wooden, but they use some sort of vessels. Like we have the mud tawa, then like terracotta, yeah, it's there, those kadais and all, but sometimes we can cook in that type of vessels. But daily life, children, if you ask your mother, she is going to tell yes, steel vessels, aluminium vessels are best for cooking, as those are metals and they conduct heat very soon. Okay, whereas non-metals, at least it's where never you, let's take example, I said oxygen. When I'm speaking about non-metals, you are going to think about oxygen. When you, obviously oxygen cannot be, we have never seen oxygen vessels because, yeah, it's a gas, children, yes. So children, non-metals, when you heat any of the non-metals, they do not conduct heat, but they burn. They are going to burn. Okay, let's take example of other one, carbon. That is coal. In the last chapter we have seen coal, it's a non-metal. When you heat it, when you burn it, it's not going to conduct any, it's not going to pass on. Obviously when you burn, it's going to burn off, yeah, it's going to burn into flames, it's going to form flames there, but it's not going to act like any kind of conductor there, it's not going to conduct any kind of heat. So children, this was the fifth differentiation, that is about the conduction of heat. Also, we have the conduction of electricity. Electricity, that means now, like just now I said, when you're going to on the button, immediately when you on the button, fatak say the fan is going to on, even fatak say the light will on. Yeah, is that when you, it's not going to happen that if I'm going to on the button and then after 1 hour, 2 hour, the light is going to, yeah, it's not going to happen. Immediately, as soon as you on the button, the current will pass through the wires and very soon the fan will get on. Immediately, within a fraction of a second, the fan will on, get on, even the bulbs are going to on. So this is the, mainly the conductors used in the wires are metals, okay? And children, silver. Silver, I think everybody knows silver anklets, bracelets and all materials we use. Silver is the best conductor in among all the metals. Okay, best conductor. It conducts electricity very soon, very fast. It's going to conduct the electricity. The thing is, we don't make use of the silver. We don't make use of silver for making wires. Obviously, you know the reason. Silver is very expensive. We cannot make use of silver wires. Next day, your wires are going to get vanished off. If you have wires, any of the wires outside, all thieves are going to rob those wires, children, because silver wires, it's not possible. It's a very, very expensive, children. The next thing, the next material which is used for making wires are copper. Okay, where I am. The next material which conducts best, best conductor of electricity, that is copper. So copper, mainly you open, now just do a task, children, don't open a live wire, but if you have any, ask your parents, any wire is there in the house, just like don't cut any wire from your house, don't do that. But if you observe any of the wire, old headphones or anything, if you have in your house, cut it and open and see what is there in that. You will find a gold, like very brownish, very nice brown color, brownish wire inside that. And that brown material is copper. Because copper is the best conductor of electricity, which can be brought in use, which can be, because it's cheaper also and it can be used, it can be, it has the property of ductility also. So this was about the conduction of electricity. Here, children, if I'm going to use a metal, the bulb will glow because metals, they are good conductor of electricity. If I'm going to take a non-metal, obviously oxygen, if I'm going to put just charcoal there, charcoal cannot be converted into wires. We cannot make wires out of charcoal. Obviously, it cannot be used. Charcoal is a non-metal, a coal, that's a coal. We cannot make use of coal for making wires and we cannot, it's a non-conductor. So here the difference, this was the sixth differentiation. The first differentiation which we had studied is about the lustrous, that is shiny, hardness, that was the second one, malleability, that means we can convert into thin sheets, Then we have the ductility. Then we have the conduction of heat. Then we have the conduction of electricity. And next one is, last one is the, so share stop me. Last one is sonority. Okay. Now I'm banging something. I'm banging something, children. Go back to your school days, children. I know you're missing your school so much. Just go back to your school days, and you will be waiting for one thing, that is your lunch break bell. The bell is one center of attraction. All the students, they love that bell. Whenever bell rings, there will be a positive energy in you, children. Yes, you're going to, yes, now the next period. Yes, now the next period. You are just going to wait for the, yeah, you just paid some, yeah, you are just going to, it's a different kind of, I'm not saying that waiting for school to get over, but it's a very, it's a kind of attraction, children. You're attracted to that sound of the bell, children. Something positive runs within you when you hear that bell. So that bell, children,
Shreya, stop making noise.
That bell is made up of metal. Okay, metal. Is that any oxygen bell or coal on that coal, carbon, that is coal? If you sit and bang on that coal, you are not going to hear any sound. But when the bells, they are rung in the school, in the temples, in the we have any wind chimes in the house, very beautiful, they give out very beautiful sound. So because metals have that property of sonority, that is producing sound. Mainly all the metals, they are used for making bells and any kind of musical instruments, because they have the tendency, they have the capability of producing sound. Okay, so in a house also, if you observe, bang any of the vessels, dang dang dang, when your mother is angry, when she'll find, sometimes it may happen, she's like, she's going to cook food, even if Chinese wala, if you have seen the way he bangs the fork and thada thada thada, lot of noise you're going to hear that sound when anybody cooks food, because all the metals are dashing to one another. Yeah, that ladle, that spoon, it dashes to one another, like that vessel. So because of that, sound is produced. So why sound is produced? Because metals have the property of sonority. And opposite to that, non-metals, that is rubber. You sit and bang your rubber. You will not hear any kind of sound. So this is a property of non-sonority, which non-metals have. Okay, so this was about the properties of, this was this year we have completed the physical properties of metals and non-metals. I am speaking, do not just distract me, children. So today we have seen about the periodic table, children. When in the olden era, when many of the elements were introduced, gold, silver, copper, zinc, many elements were introduced. So scientists were worried how to study them, where to keep them, how to tell people that these all elements are there in the nature, how to tell them, it was very difficult for scientists to make people aware that there are so many elements around us, there are so many non-metals around us. But that difficulty, that problem, that obstacle was solved by few scientists. Yeah, Dobiner, we have, I'll just take names so that just you don't have to, you will be studying in a higher class, but even though Mendeleev is one of the scientists, Dobiner is one of the scientists, Newland. These three were very dedicated scientists. They just gave simpler ideas. They failed in their attempts, but at least they introduced the ideas of arranging the elements in the periodic table. So then further, the modern periodic table, okay, Moseley, Henry Moseley was the person who introduced this modern periodic table, where he tried, because still it is a kind of failure only, children. This periodic table which we are studying, children, it's still not yet like a perfect one. Because why it is not perfect, children? Because just observe it. If I'm saying that, yes, miss, you now you will tell, miss, you have told us that metals are towards one side, non-metals towards one side. But if you observe, one of the fellow is there in the, there, it is an exception. One non-metal is there in the metal side. Yeah, you will observe hydrogen. Yeah, at the top you are going to see one non-metal which is just interfered in the metal section. So this is still not perfect, children. This periodic table is still not perfect, but we are studying it. Yeah, we have to study because no, there's no other option now. And this here and there, this periodic table is being studied by every like everywhere in the whole world. Like every curriculum follows this because even though it has some drawbacks, it has some limitation. That one fellow, this hydrogen, if you observe, it's a non-metal and it has come in neighbor. Metals ke jagah mein aaya. Yeah, it's a drawback, children. But fine, we are studying it. And then in the modern periodic table, children, as you have seen, the red ones, all the red ones are the metals. They have shine, they are lustrous, they are hard, they are conductors, they are good conductors of heat, they are good conductors of electricity. All the metals are, they have very positive properties. Whereas non-metals are all non-properties, like non-lustrous, they are non-shiny, they are bad conductor of heat, they are bad conductor of electricity. All the negative properties these non-metals they have, which are colored in blue. Now at least I said metalloids, so yeah, it follows the property of metals as well as the non-metals. It has yellow ones are very few, children, hardly six are there. And out of six, silicon is the metalloid which we use in our day-to-day life. I'll just show you one example at the end. And about the periodic table we have studied, children. Then we have seen about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. If I'm saying physical, physical means bahar ke properties. Whatever, like for example, let's take example of watermelon. If I'm going to say, if I'm going to ask you to describe watermelon, you're going to say, Miss, it is round. Miss, it is green in color. Miss, it is some watermelons, they are oval. Yeah, like they have different shape. They are spherical, something. Yeah, they have everybody. So looking at the bahar ke properties, okay, looking at the particular material, when you describe it, those are the physical properties. Now today, children, we have seen the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So the first physical property which we had seen was the luster, that means shiny. Isko shine, isko shine nahi hai. All the metals, they have shine, they have a very beautiful shine, and all the non-metals, they have no shine, they have dull surface. Next one, children, hardness. All the metals are hard, all the non-metals are soft. Next property is about the malleability. All the metals are malleable, all the non-metals are non-malleable. If you observe, all the metals have positive properties. Non-metals to bichara non hi hai, kuch bhi property, all the negative properties. So ductility, if you observe, all the metals are ductile. And if you observe, all the non-metals are non-ductile. Let's see the next property, conduction of heat. Ye heat conduct karta hai, all the metals, they conduct heat. Whereas non-metals, they do not conduct heat. Conduction of electricity, if you observe, children, electricity means all metals they conduct, mainly maximum number of metals they conduct electricity, and non-metals they do not conduct electricity. Last property is sonority. All the metals they produce sound. They nice, when you bang anything in your house, if they produce sound, okay, don't bang your brothers and sisters and she will produce sound on here, she will start crying. Don't do that banging work. Banging, but I'm telling to bang the materials. Materials means if you bang door, if you bang something and just if you get that beautiful sound, okay, you can just say that they have the property of sonority. Okay, that means metals are sonorous, non-metals are non-sonorous. Okay, let's see the next property, children. These were the properties. I'll just show you some pictures. You have to tell me which property it is, okay? I will just, everybody has to speak out now. Let's tell me this, what property it is?
Very good, children.
Brilliant, children. That means the metal is converted into wires. You can see that it is rewounding of the wires is going on. That is the ductility. Let's see, children, last 5 minutes and listen carefully. Next one, tell me which property it is. What it is? Everybody is quiet. What happened? Are you there? Can you see the picture? Malleability. Which property it is? you feel like it's different color of chocolate. Children, it's not a chocolate. Don't think about chocolates. This is the rooftop. Okay, rooftop. That is the plain roofs which are used for the construction of houses. Different type of roofs are used, children. Garages, and you find that in the parking lot. Yeah, these are the malleability. Very good. Let tell me that this property. Okay, fine. Let's see. Tell your, just tell me. Conduction of heat. Very good for that. Did you get, children, why the heat? Okay, very good, children, very good. Now just tell me why the pans, they have a plastic handle. Children, if you observe pans, all the pans, mainly nowadays the new trend is the new trendy pans. If you observe, they have nice handle which is made up of plastic, which is made up of a different type of plastic. Why, children? This, did you get the correct idea? Because the pan, when you keep it on the burner, is going to get heated up. Yes, very good. And when you go to touch the pan, because it's a good conductor of heat, and when you touch the pan, your finger will get burned off. In order to, like, these modern vessels, they have nice plastic handles, children. They have nice good handles, so that when you touch the handle, obviously that plastic do not conduct heat. It's a non-metal, so that it's easily that like it can be brought in use, children. Your mother can easily pick up the vessel with which has the plastic handles. But if they have the, they have old vessels of aluminium, big vessels, still they use the cloth, they use all that tongs to lift up the vessels. But here in the, now the modern trendy vessels, they have nice good handles. And this, because like this conduction property was known, then only like we can just, you can see the like people, they make use of, like, now trendy vessels, at least nice good vessel, modern vessels, at least they have the plastic handles, because plastic is a poor conductor of heat. Let's see the next one. This is all, yeah, look and see the same picture, the plastic handles. If you touch that also, yeah, that hand gets burned off. But when you have the plastic handle, because plastic is a poor conductor of heat, it's not going to conduct the, yeah, there's some application, it's not going to, you're not, your hand is not going to get burned off. So this type of application based questions will be asked, like why handles of pans are made up of plastic. So you should be able to answer that is due to the conduction property. What property it is, children? This one.
Tell me your
conduction of electricity, but which material? Look and see, it's a moving picture. Now you have to look at the picture properly and tell me which picture or which material conducts electricity. Kaun sa material attach kiya and the bulb glows? Tell me.
Copper,
steel.
Very good, so brilliant. Copper. Yes, very good, sir.
Because this material, yes.
Very good, Shudu.
Yes, because, yeah, very good, Shudu. So because the metals have the property of conductivity, they are the good conductors of electricity, and they can conduct electricity. Let's see last one, and then I'll just tell, I think this is already discussed, but even though, here which property you can find out?
Malleability,
that means a material can be converted into sheet. I hope so, children. Yeah, malleability. I hope so. You have understood what we have discussed today, children. I hope so. I'm just going to wind up because it's 2 o'clock, children. Today, immediately after this, like after 20 minutes, I'm going to send the notes. Write the notes properly in your classwork till I complete my teaching part. Okay, till I complete this chapter, complete the notes properly, write it neatly, make your chemistry book very colorful, children. Wherever you find any reactions, any important terms, color it properly. You can use orange and yellow color, only two colors you can use. Crayons you can use, don't use sketch pens. Make, highlight those terms, highlight those important words, and just make your book very neat, children, because soon, just pray that school, soon the school may reopen and it will be back to normal children. So I think you may leave children. No, like it's not like I'm not going to ask you to wait because some students are still waiting for the lunch. Okay, so let's see. Those are there now.
Thank you, children. If you have any doubts, you can message me.
Bye.
Thank you, children.
Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can message me.